Stop using Photoshop to separate your layers. I tried to split this 3D scene of Sun Wukong leaping out of a book manually, and it was impossible. We all know the pain. You try to select the hair, the floating rocks, the warriors, and it takes forever. Now it's easy. I'm using the Qwen Image Layered model in ComfyUI, and it changes everything. It does not just remove the background, it splits this complex image into 8 perfect transparent layers automatically. Look at this. It separated the background, the open book, the monkey king, the flying soldiers, and even the text. No need to select anything. You do not even have to type a prompt. Just upload and the model gives you every object in its own layer. So before we open the workflow, you need to download 3 specific files, and do not skip this part. So first we'll talk about diffusion model. You have 3 choices depending on your GPU. If you have a massive GPU, you can use the BF16 file. It's 40 GB, but for most people, I recommend option A. The FP8 mixed file, it's about 20 GB. It works perfectly if you have 16 to 24 GB of VRAM. And if you have less than 16 GB, go for option B. The GGUF version, get the Q4KM file. It's only 13 GB and runs quite smooth. Now the second one is VAE. This is critical. You must download the Qwen Image Layered VAE. Do not use this standard Qwen VAE. This special VAE has 4 channels designed to handle the alpha background. If you use the wrong one, your background will just be black. And the last 3rd one is text encoder. You need the standard Qwen 2.5 VL text encoder. And one file warning, do not use LoRAs. This is a standalone model. If you try to load character or style LoRAs, they will break the transparency layers and ruin the separation. Now let's look at the workflow. It's designed to be fast and flexible. First, look at the model loader group. I added a switch here, so you can choose the file you just downloaded. And if you grab the FP8 mixed file, use the Save Tensors option. If you grab the Q4 GGUF, so just flip the switch to GGUF. No need to unplug wires. Just pick the one that fits your hardware. Simple. Now let's come to the prompt section. This is where I save time. I created a switch for you. Option 1 is Qwen VL. This is the auto mode. The AI looks at your image and writes the description for you. Now there comes a second option. That is manual. And if you want to control exactly what the model sees, just flip the switch. It's actually quite simple. You do not need to give instructions like remove background or split layers. The killer prompt is just a clear description for the image. That's it. So if you have a photo of a cat on a table, just write a cat sitting on a wooden table. The model already knows its job to separate them. And if you overcomplicate it, the model gets confused. Now moving on, let's look at the resolution. You might wonder what resolution should I use. The model works best at 2 specific sizes. So let me tell you those sizes, 640 and 1024. For most cases, I use 640. It's faster and stable. And if you need high quality, then set it to 1024. Do not go higher than that directly or it will be very slow. Here, I added an image resize node right here to handle this. Now I'll explain the layer settings. This part usually confuses people, but I made it simple. You see the empty onion latent node? The length number here decides how many layers you get. But it's not a direct number. You can't just type 5 or 5 layers. You have to use a simple math formula. So here, I wrote it down in this note for you. It's layer times 4 plus 1. So if you want 2 layers, just the person and the background, you type 9. And if you want 3 layers, you type 30. Just look at the list I put in the note and type the number you need. So let's try an example. Here I want to split this banner into 2 layers. So here I do the math. 2 times 4 is 8 plus 1 is 9. So here I type 9 in the box. I run it with 20 steps and CFG 2.5. And here is the result. You can see image 0 is the reference. Image 1 is the background. It's clean. Image 2 is the main cartoon with dots and the text. And the cutout is perfect. Now let's go deeper. Here I want 5 layers. So I do the math. 5 times 4 is 20 plus 1 is 21. I type 21 here and I use a different image. It's a Halloween banner with a little witch, floating ghosts and bats. So here I run it again. Now look at this result. It separates the little witch with pigtails, but it also separates the Halloween text, the spider and the background with the ghost. But if you want to separate the ghost too, just increase the layer to 8. For that, we use value 33. Here we go extreme. Now we get the perfect background. The happy text is split. The beds are separate. The spider and the ghost are now in their own layer. The little witch girl is separate. And in the last layer, we have the Halloween text. It cuts them perfectly. And if you are doing motion graphics or 2.5D animation, this gives you control over every tiny element. Now let's talk about low VRAM users. How can they run this? Now switch to the GGUF option, select the Q4 model, and make sure you change the resolution in resize image to 640 by 640. Here I am using the same Halloween banner and let's test this. So if you compare it with FP8, it does not give you a good result, but it's still usable. The background is not split perfectly, but the witch girl, the ghost and the text are properly split. So even with Q4, you get the output. This model splits the hardest images in layers, which was impossible before. So that's it for today's video. If you like this, please subscribe to our channel for more videos like this.